I'm excited about the direction, so I'm excited about making this move too. Like, you know what? I was driving here happy. And then I saw my sister Nina out there. I was happy seeing her, Amina over there. And you know, this is good times for me. This is not, and write it this way. I hope, tomorrow it's gonna be, oh, imagine this. I hope it comes out right? That I had a great time. I wanna thank my sister for allowing me to do this. I couldn't face her to tell her, so I had to do it this way. Because we love each other so much.
Irvin, just because you said how impactful the interview that Jim had with LeBron was on you, have you had any communication with LeBron about
this? No.
What would you say to him?
I would just tell him, that I'm going back to doing my community work that's important to me, that I missed a lot of it. Jim and I cried together at Crenshaw High School when Nipsey died. I said, man, this is a part. That's who I am in the community. You know, I want to complete what I started there. And I think that I want to also free up to do whatever I want to do in terms of help guys like I was before. I'm a free bird and I've been handcuffed and I don't like that.
The elements of his job that it turned out you didn't enjoy as much, how surprising is that to you?
Very. It's not the job itself, and I love, you know what I love? The recruitment of LeBron. Because you get me in a room with somebody, oh, it's over. I know how to close deals. That's why I'm good in business, right? I know what to do. I'm gonna go back to that. My company is exploding right now, and so I have to make a decision, right? Because I can't give both 100%, and so I'm excited about going back to that. And this is a good day.
This has to be really hard for you, as much as you talked about winning two summers, as much as you dreamed about leading this team back. You know, I think back to press conference years ago. This must be really hard for you.
It's a difficult decision. You know, I cried before I came here. I'm about to cry now. But. It's hard when you love an organization the way I love this organization. It's hard when you love a person like I love Jeannie. And I don't want to disappoint her. I don't want to, you know, we love Luke, you know. So I got to make a decision, right? And that's a tough thing. But I'm good with where I am. I'm happy. I want to do the things I used to do. So I had to weigh both situations, and so this is better for me.
I know how religious a person you are, and I would assume that you prayed about this.
Oh, I did. That's why I'm happy. You know, God gave me the right decision, and so that's why I'm happy and moving forward.
Magic, you keep saying you didn't want to be between me and him. Can you just clarify
Well, what I mean is that...
Who's the him?
No, when I say that between him... Look, Jeannie loves Luke, loves me. You know, you never want to have to make a decision that then... I don't never want to disappoint her. And it's a tough situation. So... we have so much love for Lakers, you know, and this organization. So I looked and I said, you know what, Irvin? You got a great life. I mean, I was like, man. And when I got done praying about it and thinking about it, I said, go back to that great life. I still help the Lakers in any way I can if they call me and need me. Matter of fact, I loved our dinners before and after the season with Jeannie. I'll go back to that, and then let somebody come in here or whatever she decides to do, and I support that. And Allison, thank you, honey. I know you were trying to cut me off, and she was like, what is Magic doing?
Magic, was there any...
Thank you, but I love you. I enjoy working with you.
Irvin, if you and Jeannie had been on the same page with...
We are on the same page. In terms of, she gave me the power. That was the same page. And I could have did anything I wanted to do tomorrow. But I decided to step down, and we've always been on the same page. We've never had an argument or a disagreement. She told me even yesterday, you have the power. So...
And you thought it would hurt her if you got rid of Lou?
No, I just didn't want to put her or myself in that situation, right? And so I'm good with who I am, what I stand for, what I'm all about, and I love her to death. And so this is a great moment for me, great moment for her, the organization, and let's just move forward. We support him and keep it moving.
Was there any outside pressure?
No.
This all came from...
No, I don't succumb to outside pressure. You know me. I stand by anything I do. I don't worry about what people say. All these articles, this, that did never bother me. I'm a strong man. So the only pressure would have been if it was her and I at each other. But that never happened. You know, I only had one boss. That's who I had to deal with. And she was on board. We had a great meeting yesterday. So I enjoyed it.
Would the Lakers benefit, in your opinion, from reaching out to another luminary from their past to perhaps fill the position you're leaving?
It's up to Jeannie. I don't know what she would want to do, but I support anything she wants to do. That's what it's all about. Lakers, we stick together, and we're going to continue to do that. I'm telling you, we're only one step away. Next year, we're going to be good. If we get one of these guys, we're going to be really, really good.
Do you leave with any regrets, Magic? Is there any one thing you regret?
Nope. Not one.
What do you think? How are they going to get another? You were the guy that's supposed to get them another star. How are they going to go out and do that?
Oh, they'll get another one. I mean, because the team is in place. Did anybody see this team? Everything is in place. We add one guy, and this team is in the finals, in the Western Conference Finals. Because we're not too far away from everybody. Before we got hurt, we were in fourth, two games away from being in first, right? Playing some good basketball. And I think that we can continue to do that. Hey, listen, you know, tomorrow, you know how many calls Jeannie gonna get for this job? This is a coveted job, trust me. It'll be somebody good in. And Lee, thank you, man.
You're welcome.
For the sweet, the tickets across for the concerts.
You'll always have that.
Thank you, sir. And then look at Stu. Stu all mad at me. Oh, imagine what you're doing. You know I love you, man. You my man. And watch out for your partner there. I love enjoy listening to him. Uh-oh. Michael Thompson's guy over there. There. Go ahead.
Magic, you mentioned the meeting you had yesterday. Was there anything that came out of that that led to this, or had you been thinking about this?
No, I've been thinking about it for a little, but no, it was a great meeting. She said, hey, you know, whatever direction you want to take the franchise, go ahead. I'm behind you. Because I think she was really concerned when people thought we were not connected, and that was further from the truth.